I'll be remembered, but will you? Till McDonald's the baddest that I would turn to. CEO with the shit, that's a dumb motherfucker. He always wins. There's no going under. The top of the crown resting on his head. The beast is alive, he'll never be dead. If he drunk before, bring it back to life. Push harder for it. Let us survive. Show courage and strength. It's okay to be scared, but don't let it stop you. Always stay prepared. Bill Showman School, they're just not beginning. Winners fucking win, losers talk about winning.
What is up, guys? Welcome to the Beer to Beast Show. My name is Bill, and I am the Bearded Beast. With that noise, I guess you can assume what today's episode is probably about. We're going to talk about the real meaning of the 4th of July. Yes, it's cookouts. It's good food. Time to spend with family and friends. Some good music, and of course, enjoying in some fireworks. And hopefully, you can find someone who's got fireworks as good as the ones that I was just playing. But really, more importantly, it is Independence Day. But what makes Independence Day so special? What gives the 4th of July its significance? Is that our Declaration of Independence was adopted by the Continental Congress in 1776. It was in Philadelphia, and the signers of that document, composed by Thomas Jefferson, knew that this Declaration of Independence from the dictatorial rule of Great Britain might also be their death sentence. They knew full well that the wrath and might of the British Army would be sailing across the Atlantic to descend on the defenseless colonies. They knew their scattered states didn't have the numbers or the arms or the training to stand against the British, much less defeat them. Yet, they put their signatures, their lives, their families, and their destiny on that parchment. And so against all odds, and even against reason, the Declaration told the world that these united colonies are of right ought to be free and independent states. The only importance of the 4th day of July then was it marked the birth of the United States of America. Listen to that again. It marked the birth of the United States of America. And those very words should send shivers up your spine as it does mine. Most of the people living in those colonies had simply had enough of the British domination, of working and virtually existing at the pleasure of a king they didn't know and who considered them his indentured servants. They wanted to be free, to make their own decisions, to govern themselves, and breathe the sweet air of liberty. The first celebration of American independence took place 4 days later in Philadelphia, where the Continental Congress was still meeting. The ceremony began with a public reading of the Declaration of Independence. Then, from the tower of the State House, now called Independence Hall, the Liberty Bell rang out. The coat of arms of the King of England was taken down, and there was a parade. Cannons boomed. The people, aware of what lie ahead, cheered. A new nation sprang to life. That's what this day is meant to be about. John Adams himself, a signer of the Declaration, thought that all Americans should henceforth celebrate a great anniversary festival. In a letter to his wife Abigail, he wrote, "It ought to be commemorated as the day of deliverance, a solemn act of devotion to God Almighty. It ought to be solemnized with pomp and parade, with shows, games, sports, guns, bells, bonfires, and illuminations from one end of this continent to the other, from this time forward forevermore." So it began. A more elaborate celebration was held there in 1788 after the new Constitution had been ratified. There was a larger parade, speeches, an extravagant dinner. But what you need to understand is between those two celebrations in 1776 and 1788, there was horrible, horrible fighting, rivers of bloodshed, the deaths, bankruptcies of many of the signers of the Declaration, families torn apart, businesses and farms were destroyed. The freedoms declared by the Declaration and ushered into fact by the Constitution were secured at a terrible, terrible cost. Soon across the nation at sunrise on July 4th, salutes were fired, bells were rung, flags were flown from buildings, from homes, and along the streets. Shop windows were decorated with red, white, and blue, and churches held special services. What's Independence Day like today? Do most people you know actually make time to purposely celebrate our independence in meaningful ways? And even while we're again locked in a deadly combat on foreign soil, still involving hundreds of thousands of our finest young men and women, what is it that they're fighting for now? Is it anything like what motivated our Revolutionary Army? Is it freedom from religion? How about this concept? Explain to me what the necessity to take under God out of our pledges. Some people you talk to would like to do away with it altogether. What is that all about? What makes them right? You're going to tell me that you're offended by the words under God. This is the United States of America. We are given rights and opportunities to voice our opinions. But why does it seem, and maybe it just seems that way to me, that most of the things that our country were founded on, groups of individuals have issues with it, and all of a sudden, we have to make drastic changes? It's my right as an American to have under God stay in our Pledge of Allegiance. What about the right to end lives of unwanted babies? Is that what we're fighting for? Or are we fighting for the right for two men and two women to marry? Or is it still the impossible dream of a nation under God with unalienable rights endowed equal to all? And among these, life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Take this day and cherish that original dream, the one for which so many have died, to individually and collectively redeclare our independence from tyranny, despotism, taxation without representation, and debts that no free society should ever bear. An allegiance to the blood-bought foundation of government, of, by, and for the people. People who are determined to live free. On this day that is so important, Independence Day, the birth of the United States of America, let's talk about the Pledge of Allegiance. It was written in August of 1892 by the socialist minister Francis Bellamy. It was originally published on September 8th of 1892, and he had hoped that the pledge would be used by citizens in any country. In its original form, it read, "I pledge allegiance to my flag and the republic for which it stands, one nation, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all." In 1923, the words, "the flag of the United States of America," were added. So at that time, it read, "I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all." In 1954, President Eisenhower encouraged Congress to add the words under God, creating the 31-word pledge that we say today. Not 29 words, 31. And that reads, "I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all." Here's something that's been irritating me for the past year or so, and I'm going to talk about it. Even though this is our day to talk about Independence Day and our podcast was the real meaning of the 4th of July, well, this does have meaning, and this does have to do with independence and the 4th of July. What's this new form of protest that we kneel during the national anthem? We all know who it was started by. I don't need to bring that up. But I actually saw someone sing the national anthem at a basketball game and kneel while they did it. I get it. They have the right to do this. They're protesting something I guess they feel passionate about. And in the United States of America, we have the right to do that. We have the right for free speech and to protest. But I'm sorry, as a proud American, which I am, I have a huge problem with the way they are protesting. And I would never think of taking a knee during the national anthem. We just talked about the 4th of July, the birth of the United States of America, our independence. The American flag represents American history, starting from when we fought for our independence, gained our independence, and then went on to become the greatest nation in the world. Our flag represents our strength, our weaknesses, and everything in between. I respect my country and our history, and I think we've come a long way and continue to be the best, and we always strive for greatness. I would never consider kneeling for the fact being that our heritage, our history, and what our flag symbolizes and what it means to us as an American. Whether things are good or bad, I don't agree with everything that we do, but I would never consider kneeling during our national anthem. Secondly, at the events that we're choosing to kneel, if you look on the fields, there's soldiers that are holding the flags right in front of these people. There's always soldiers at sporting events where we're choosing to display this protest. Taking a kneel in front of them shows great disrespect. Whether you mean it or not, realize it or not, it does. Who are you to kneel? While the men and women standing in front of you have fought to give you that right to kneel, they've done unimaginable things, shown bravery for everyone, for all the people of America. And the flag represents that. Yes, understand that, because I think a lot of people have forgot that. The flag represents the soldiers who fight for the United States of America. And some people seem to be confused. The flag to me represents who I am, and that is American. It represents the past, but it also represents the future as well. The national anthem is so sacred, and so is the flag. Both are two things and ways we can show our pride, remembrance, and encouragement for our country. It represents our soldiers, the ones who are fighting now, the ones who have fought, and the ones who have died, giving their lives for this country. I'm standing for myself, my country, my family, and for the men and women who have fought so hard to give me the right and for me to have the freedoms in this great country. I stand because I'm a proud American. If I was ever wanting to protest something or felt passionate about an issue that was not being treated right, I would not choose to kneel during the national anthem. To me, the American flag and the national anthem are off limits. They deserve much more than taking a knee. They deserve a hand over our heart, hats off of our head, and we are standing on 2 feet. And I will always do that because I'm a proud American who respects my country. McDonald the craft, my God, master at work. Inspiration never ending as I craft these words. Miracle master with a pen and a pen and my vision on a mission with precision. So go deep in the definition. That's cuz I go hard like the bearded beast. And when I get knocked down, I get back on my feet. Always look up so you can't look down on me. I'm the best alive. That's me.